ओके, सो इट डेवलप्स अ टेम्पररी डायपोल मोमेंट एंड इट इज नाउ द इंटरैक्शन बिटवीन द पॉजिटिव, नाउ इट अट्रैक्ट्स द नेगेटिव एंड नेट इन द नेट देयर इज एन अट्रैक्शन. ओके, सो एंड इफ दिस डायपोल मूव्स अवे फ्रॉम हियर व्हाट हैपेंस, दैट मॉलिक्यूल बिकम्स अ नॉन पोलर अगेन बैक. ओके, सो द सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट द इंटरैक्शन एनर्जी इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू 1/r⁶, वेयर ऑब्वियसली आर इज द डायपोल और डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द डायपोल एंड द इंड्यूस्ड डायपोल. ओके, फाइन. And as we discussed, the dipole moment that develops in this molecule depends on the polarizability of it. The dipole moment induced in the non-polar molecule depends on the polarizability, that is the susceptibility, the polarizability or the susceptibility chi e of the material. You'll come across this term when you understand that the polarization, which is the total dipole moment, net dipole moment per unit volume, is equal to chi e multiplied by the electric field. So higher the susceptibility, and it is this which is known as electrical susceptibility. Okay, because there is also magnetic susceptibility. This is electrical susceptibility. Yes, you were asking something.
It's a figure of merit or a
degree? No, it depends what you are trying to do. No, suppose you don't want to polarize it, then it becomes a figure of demerit. But if you actually are looking into polarization, then it's a figure of merit. The higher the value, more is the polarization. You can very well see it's a figure of merit if you're concerned about polarization, right? Mm-hmm. So if you want to polarize and I have this as some value, then the one with the higher value of the susceptibility will develop more polarization. P is the polarization. This is polarizability is the ability to be polarized, right? So this is not polarizability. This is net dipole moment. This is called polarization, which is net dipole moment per unit volume. Moment per unit volume, correct? You understand? It is net dipole moment per unit volume polarization. So what I mean to say is suppose this is a material and you have an electric field like that, and which obviously say passes through the material, then in the bulk of this material it is, you know, okay, so what happens, there'll be so many
Okay, so there'll be minus here and plus here, and minus and plus and minus and plus.
So what happens actually? These minus and pluses, they each have an individual dipole moment, and in physics it points from negative to positive, and since they are in the same direction, so you see they start adding up. And if you do this for the whole of the bulk, that is what is the polarization. So you do it for 1 mm³, and if you are able to know the total dipole moment, you divide by 10 to the power minus 6, that will become the total number of dipole moments per unit volume, if it is uniformly polarized, right? Okay? Now, so higher the polarizability, more is the force of attraction. Higher the polarizability, more is the force of attraction. Okay? More is the force of attraction. And in this case also, the cumulative effect of the dispersion forces and the dipole induced forces exists. Hope you understand what we mean by the dispersion forces, because this dipole itself may be subject to some transient variations due to something else. Okay, so this transient variation to which this is subjected may induce an additional dipole apart from its own permanent dipole, right? So this is permanently, this has got a dipole moment of something, and suppose suddenly it comes under some electric field, then this dipole may stretch or may be reduced, right? In the transient, it may increase or reduce. It may increase or reduce, okay?